Thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to be reviewing the Ascend Aeronautics ASC-2680 camera drone. If you've been to your local Costco or big box store, you may have come across the Ascend Aeronautic drones. These are pretty affordable budget price drones that have cameras on there and typically have sales, so they're all usually very cheap. In this review, we're going to be looking at the latest version of the drone, which is the ASC-2680, has the upgraded camera, as well as some other features that make it easier to fly. You can see packaging wise, nice big plastic opening so you can actually see the entire drone, which is nice when you're shopping. You can see the remote, the drone, basic branding on here, and then the specs printed on the back side. As far as the packaging, it's pretty simple, but definitely a lot of plastic, and you can see windows all along it. What's interesting here is on the top, it actually says open from the bottom, so you're not actually supposed to open it from that side. So go ahead and open this up from the bottom, as it says. So retail price on this is actually $49.99. That's when it's on sale, which seems to be most of the time. This is a quadcopter drone. So you can see you have four propellers, which is a pretty stable design and pretty friendly. You have a 1080p high definition camera, which is really nice. So it lets you actually get a little higher quality footage. Now, once you get it out of the packaging, this is what you have. You see you have the drone, it's a nice folding design, so very compact. You have the battery. You only get one battery with this, so you do have to be aware of that. And then the micro USB cable to charge the battery. You get the remote control with this little attachment piece to put your cell phone onto it. You have spare propeller blades, which is nice. So if you were to crash the drone and break a plastic blade, you do have replacements. You also have a little screwdriver and a micro SD reader. So it's actually kind of nice. It's a USB reader, so you attach this to your USB port and then you can read the memory card. Note, there is no memory card here, so you do have to purchase that separately. You can use this without a memory card, but to get the higher quality video, you do want that memory card. That's the only way to get the full 1080. Then you also have the instruction manual, which is definitely worth reading before you start flying. Now let's take a look at the weight of the drone. So the drone by itself comes in really lightweight. It's only 188 grams, and it's actually on purpose. There's a lot of regulations for drones over 250 grams. So by keeping them lightweight, it's a lot easier to fly and requires less rules. The controller with the batteries in it and the little cell phone holder is almost the same weight at 185 grams. The Ascend Aeronautics ASC-2680 uses a compact quadcopter design with folding wings that makes it really easy to transport. This quadcopter design is really popular because it's very stable. So you can see you have four blades and they actually rotate counterclockwise into each other, which makes it very easy to maneuver and stable to hover. This actually has a folding design as well. So you can see you fold the bottom ones in first, upper ones after, and then it's a very portable design, so you can actually just carry this or throw it in a bag. So you do just have to make sure you get the blades in. And then you can see all together, it's very compact and lightweight. The main body of the drone is just plastic, which is not surprising. You have this almost perforated design, so it helps cool the internal electronics and makes it pretty robust to crashing as well. You have a single access camera on the front, and it is not powered, so you can see it actually has slots. So you have to adjust it before you fly to get the angle that you prefer. Unlike higher end drones, which actually have multiple gimbals and adjustments, this one is a rigid setup. This has a 1080 camera though, which is really nice. So you get higher fidelity video than you did with the previous version. You can also see there's quite a bit of light on here. So that really helps orientate you when you're flying. So you can see if I open this up again, there are lights on the front, a big light on the back, and then lights on the bottom. So it makes it easy to fly and keep track of where it is. You can see the battery slides in the bottom. You only get one battery, so you do have to be aware of the battery status, and it has a micro USB port on the front to charge it with no port on the actual device. So you actually have to remove this and then recharge it. Simply slides in the back, and then you can see two blades per propeller, and you also have the replacement propellers if you were to break something. This is also very beginner friendly, which means you can fly this very easily. There's no GPS chip. Instead, it actually uses optical flow, so you can see there's a downward facing camera here, and that actually helps it figure out where it is and orientate itself so it'll be more stable even in light wind. This is a beginner drone, so you don't really want to use this at very high altitudes or speeds. And instead, it's more of a kind of recreational style that can also capture video or pictures. As far as the remote, you can see you have a nice plastic remote control, two joysticks, and a lot of buttons. So you actually have these toggle switches on each side, on the bottom, power button, and then the hover here. And then two labeled buttons on the back, one is speed and one is stunt. You also have this little plastic attachment piece, which lets you put a cell phone on there, and it's spring-loaded to hold in place, and that's really nice if you want to fly it first person and see where you're going. So a nice little feature. It has the standard control, so you have the up and down motion, yaw and pitch, so you can pitch it up and down, and also rotate it clockwise or counterclockwise. There's additional buttons here, so some of these are for trimming, so you can actually adjust the trim, and that makes it more stable when it's hovering. By default, it is calibrated, but if you were to crash it or something were to happen, you can manually override them. You also have the power button and then the hover. So this will auto launch and then auto land. So a nice feature. So I'll automatically bring it up and hold it stable. On the back, you have two controllers. So very similar to a PlayStation or Xbox setup. One is named Stunt. So this one will do a 360 loop. So it will hold it flat and then actually take it around, flip it, all automatically with the press of a button, and then bring it back down. So kind of a cool feature. You have to make sure you're in the appropriate speed level and height to use that. And then the speed button. So this one will control the speed. You have three settings, low, medium, high. The higher the speed, the more responsive it is, but it's also more difficult to fly. So if you're more of a beginner, you can keep it in low mode. And there's also a training mode, which is kind of cool. If you hold that button down, you get a couple of beeps and acknowledgement, and then it's a slower mode that actually restricts how far it goes so you don't go out of range or crash. Now let's take a look at some flying footage of the drone. As you can hear, it's not that loud actually, despite being a little small quadcopter. A little buzzing sound, but it's not overly obnoxious. We have the video from the app directly shown on the top right. And you can fly it without the app as well. It just helps you for starting images or recordings. As you can see, you have basic control. So the right one does the basic tilt, so pinch and yaw. And then the left one, you can see you do a rotation forward, backwards, or spin around. You want to use these in combination to do tighter corners, and once you fly it more, it's a lot more intuitive. So as you can see, you can do a nice sharp corner, especially when you combine the two. There's multiple speed options as well, so you can adjust the speed from low, medium to high, and as you increase the speed, you can see it becomes more responsive. So as you become more comfortable with the drone, you can actually up the sensitivity and it becomes a lot more responsive. On the camera image, you will note there's a little bit of water splash on there, but in the normal drone, it's a nice clear shot. So with the drone, you have a lot of LEDs too, so pretty easy to see what you're doing. The red is behind it and the white's on front. You also have that stunt mode, which is kind of cool. So you initiate stunt mode and make sure you're at least 6 feet higher off the ground. And then you can do a flip. So you can see here, we'll slow it down. So it does a little flip depending on which direction you push the right joystick. Otherwise, the drone's pretty easy to fly. It's obviously very lightweight, so in any type of wind, it'll just drift away. So you do have to be careful of that. But you do have the nice one-touch landing and launching. So you can see, just press the button and it'll do a nice safe landing. But otherwise, a fun drone, but again, don't fly as too high and don't fly too fast. The other downside of this drone is you have a mechanical camera here, so you don't have any motor on there. That means you have to manually position it. So if you want to adjust the angle, you have to stop and adust it. Here you can see a full view, a direct view from the camera. There is no image stabilization, which is one big drawback to this kind of cheap drones. They don't have any gimbals on there or even electronic stabilization. So you can see the camera image is pretty decent. It's a lot better than the 2400 drone we actually used, which was 720 DP. You have a nice wide lens, so you can see a very wide image. But again, without stabilization, it's very jarring to watch. So if you want to get slow cinematic shots, this is definitely not the drone. It's a lot more fun just to fly around and mess around with. There's also a 2680 drone app. So it's actually specific for this model. It has a basic setup screen, which tells you to connect to Wi-Fi. And once it's successful, it tells you whether it was successful or not. Then you have a live view or view your previous recordings. So you can see in the live view, you get a streaming image from the camera directly to the phone, which is pretty cool. So you can do first person perspective. You can do an image from here or start a recording. And that's really the only way to start the recording, as there's no button on the actual drone controller. So once you're flying, you can see there's no image stabilization, so it can be a little bit jarring. but it's a nice way to kind of see where you're at. You can also view any save files, so you have the photos and videos, and then you can directly upload to social media or direct connect the drone via USB cable to extract it directly to your computer. Now let's go over the pros and cons of the ASC-2680. What we like about it is that it's budget friendly. At only $50, it's a lot of drone for the price. It's also easy to fly with an intuitive user interface, so very simple controls. You have stunt mode, multiple speeds, and even alerts to tell you when you're too far away from the actual drone. It's also very portable and compact with a folding quadcopter design, so it's easy to travel with. You just tuck it into a bag and take it with you. The main negative with the drone is the fact that there is no battery status on the device or the app. So there's really no way to gauge how much battery you have left, which can be really dangerous as it ends up just crashing once the battery is low. So you do have to mentally keep track of it and make sure you don't do anything too dangerous when you're in a lower battery state. Taking everything into account, we'd give the Ascend Aero an 8.2 out of 10. It's a nice beginner-friendly drone with a decent camera. Thanks for watching this review. Don't forget to like and subscribe. You can see more content from us on our website at thesweetcyclist.com, as well as on Instagram at thesweetcyclist. This is The Sweet Cyclist, reminding you to enjoy the ride.